was just like a God-given song, I think. Or a Satan-given song.
And myself, we're going to sort of get together and form another group. And as it happens, we went round to see... we saw this advert in town, Aussie Zig requires gig, you see. And we said, oh, Aussie. I said, I know an Aussie. I said, it can't be the same Aussie. Because Aussie was at school with me, you know. I said to Billy, it can't be the same Aussie, because he didn't sing then or anything. We went round to this house, and sure enough, who should answer the door was Aussie. And it turns out they'd already got a guitar player. And I said, well, there's Bill here, but we're going together, we're going to join a group together, you know. And that's how it happened, and we ended up, the four of us, Bill, Ozzy and Geezer and myself. Well, we went along with the name Earth for a while, and then we couldn't get much work at all, because we were doing all blues, so we only could do a certain amount of blues clubs. Black Sabbath was from a 1935 horror film, a Boris Karloff film. And it was Geezer that came up with the idea of the name. Call ourselves Black Sabbath. Nobody else will have that name, you know, that's why it was.
Oh,
Like a big part of Sabbath was the not only the heaviness of it, but doing tempo changes and different timings and stuff.
On the bad side of it is, you know, these people that go and shoot themselves and things over some lyrics, and they get the whole totally wrong meaning out of it. Or all these TV evangelists, you know, they'll pick up like for instance, Hand of Doom, they'll pick up one sentence out of that and blow it up into this big thing, as if we're telling everybody to go and shoot smack, where the whole song is against doing anything, like against drugs.
Sabbath, pretty Sabbath. I mean, I got involved a lot with doing the production side of it, which I didn't particularly want to. I was interested in it, but didn't really want to get involved in it. But somehow I got shoved in the deep end to get involved from there to there, and I've done a few albums after that. Because I originally went to LA to write that album, because the album before that, Volume 4, we rented a house there, and it was great, and we really enjoyed it. And so we thought, well, the next album, well, let's go back there again. We rent the same house, which we did, and same studio, everything.
And there's one song, I dreamt the whole song. And I woke up and wrote the whole, all the words down. And at rehearsals that day, I picked my bass up and played it to Tony, the riff, and we just did it there and then. Told him exactly what to do and everything. It's really weird.
This day now, how we write now, I've got such a close relationship with Geezer that we sit down together and just we automatically know what we're going to, we come out with, we start doing it, it'll follow exactly. It's just that communication for all these years that it just sort of clicks. And we put riffs down and ideas down on the tape and then wait for a melody to be put on and then go from there, what part it'll need for a change or whatever, you know.
I just wanted to relate what was going on in my head. It's the only way I could communicate with people was just to put the lyrics to the songs that were coming out. Sit down with Ozzy, he'd come up with the melody line, and then we'd finish the song, and then me and him would just sit down and I'd write the lyrics and fit them around his vocal line.
Musically, no, we sort of, things we were doing, we just knew it was right, we just felt it was right, and then there wouldn't be a lot of question about, oh, we're not going to play that, or what. We just felt it was the right thing, musically. certain things come about that you can't explain. Just a certain feeling you have, and you know things are right, or you know, like in Guy's case, things he's written about have amazed me. And I'm bloody hell, that's really good, really, you know, great idea. So he's each to their own. I mean, I couldn't come up with stuff like he comes up with. It's great.
Oh yeah, it's beyond friendship. It's just like true soulmate. It really is. It's just like almost psychic, really.
Stages with us. One time I think he wanted to leave and he left and then came back and then he wanted to leave again.
Oh, realise I'd rather that's the right word for it. Not, yeah, all that period of realising it was good. I mean, I don't regret it. It's something that had to happen in all our lives, I think, for all of us.
Totally lost interest in anything that we were doing at the time, and hardly ever turned up for rehearsals. And we went over to America to start the Heaven and Hell album. And he turned up about a month later, and he just wasn't into it. So we needed to get on with writing the album, and so we just came to the decision that. We had to part company.
We rehearsed in his castle once in Wales, it was. We used to rehearse in the dungeons, which was the dungeons of the castle. And one day we were in this one room, we had a fire, big fire going. And Ozzy fell asleep on the couch. And we walked out and we got out. Anyway, a piece of coal fell out and when I caught on fire, and of course Ozzy managed to get out. And I think, I don't know if later on that day, we saw this, we walked out down the passage. And there was an armory on the left as we walked down, on the right as we walked down. And we saw this figure coming towards us. and then go into this armory. And we thought, who's this guy like? And so we went into this armory, Ozzy and myself. Of course, there was nobody there. The door's locked from the inside at the other end. I was like, God, that's strange. And I've got to be honest, we frightened the life out of each other. We had to leave in the end. Everybody terrified each other because we were playing jokes on each other. Nobody knew who was doing it, you know, and it just got ridiculous. So we used to leave and drive all the way home and drive back the next day. It's really silly.
Yeah, all scaring ourselves. Yeah, I mean, there was like this satanic band all driving home every night because everybody was frightened to stay at the place. When Ozzy got off stage, I mean, the gig was crap. I mean, it was all right, it was just a gig in Sweden. And there was this kid, he had to be about 10 years old in front. And this bloke came up and started beating the hell out of this little kid. So Ozzy jumped off stage. And he absolutely murdered this bloke. And the next day, we were leaving the hotel, and this guy comes up with his arm in a sling, broken arm, a broken leg. And he comes and he says, "Excuse me, I was the one that Ozzy beat up last night, but I was on LSD. I'm really sorry for what happened." And oh no, he was on acid, and Ozzy did that to him. And then he came up for our autographs the next day.
It's on my arm.